The GMC Yukon and its long-wheelbase variant, the Yukon XL, don't offer as much driving enjoyment or brand cachet as the Mercedes-Benz GLS 450. In addition, the Yukon's uninspiring interior materials raise serious questions as to its value compared with its nearly identical corporate siblings, the Chevrolet Tahoe and Suburban. But the Yukon is not without charms. There's the Corvette-derived 420 horsepower 6.2-liter V8 that powers Yukon's outfitted in the top Denali trim. The engine is also available in certain Chevrolet Tahoes. A new 10-speed automatic pairs with that engine in a semi-successful attempt to improve its gluttonous fuel economy, but no Yukon will please environmentalists. Then there's its 4G LTE and Wi-Fi hotspot capability, standard in every Yukon, as are Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. For the subset of the population whose idea of a fun time includes hauling the entire family and all their stuff up a mountain while towing a travel trailer and 6 kayaks, there are few alternatives. What's new for 2018? A new 10-speed automatic matches up with the 6.2-liter V8 that powers the Denali and Denali XL versions of the Yukon. The new transmission improved the Denali's EPA fuel economy ratings slightly, but doesn't do much to alter the day-to-day driving experience. The rest of the Yukon's updates are relatively minor. There's a new chrome grille design and a new wood interior trim for Denali models, a new paint color for non-Denali models called Satin Steel Metallic, and a fill alert added to the tire pressure monitor system. There's also the new Ultimate package, available only on Denali models, which bundles the following: an extended Sirius XM trial, a motion and incline sensing alarm system for theft deterrence, a power sunroof, power retractable running boards, adaptive cruise control with forward collision warning, exterior paint accents, and 22-inch wheels. What was new for 2017? Tweaks to the 2017 Yukon and Yukon XL were few. There was increased feature availability in the mid-level SLT trim, which includes the addition of an HDMI connector, an extra USB port, digital headphones, and the ability to use a personal electronic device to project media to the available rear seat entertainment system. Active grille shutters were also added for improved aerodynamic efficiency, as well as 2 new extra cost paint colors, dark sapphire blue metallic, and an exclusive to Denali shade called mineral metallic. The Yukon's long wheelbase XL model is our pick, as its cavernous interior largely remedies the standard short wheelbase version's struggle to accommodate 7 passengers plus all of their luggage. We'd avoid the top Denali trim, and its expensive but not truly luxurious trimmings, and would choose the $61,420 SLT, which includes the following features: heated and cooled front seats, power folding second and third row seats, active safety technology, including blind spot monitoring, rear cross traffic alert, forward collision warning, and lane keeping assist. Frequent road trippers may be tempted by the $3,480 open road package, which adds navigation, a sunroof, and a rear seat entertainment system, or the $780 heavy-duty trailering package. The Yukon's selectable all-wheel drive system costs an additional $3,000, so even a moderately optioned Yukon XL represents a serious investment.
Phones, Babylon's can't